1973, a surprise attack on Israel by Egypt and Syria ignited the Yom Kippur War. Israel's tank forces, which had previously seemed invincible, suffered devastating losses. For 40 years, the most potent anti-tank weapon on the battlefield had been another tank. But in this war, Egyptian soldiers had another effective option.
There was an introduction of something that changed the equation on the battlefield, and that was this light, portable anti-tank weapon.
The Israeli tanks were being attacked by missiles that could be carried in suitcases and by rocket-propelled grenades. Anti-tank explosives had been around since World War II, but the missiles were a major improvement. A portable guided delivery system with a deadly warhead. Known as shaped charges, the warheads were designed to cut through even the thickest tank armor.
This is a shaped charge. The top part here is filled with explosive. This is designed so that when the explosion travels down here, this copper actually turns to liquid and is concentrated on a point down here. And that allows the liquid metal to actually puncture straight through the target.
It will completely carve up the crew, or it will set off ammunition fires, which in turn, of course, will produce internal explosions, which will completely finish them.
But of course, as soon as engineers realized what they were up against, they began searching for the next protective counterpunch to defend against it. In 1969, German armor scientist Manfred Held made a surprising discovery while conducting research in the Middle East. Held was testing shaped charge warheads on the wrecks of battle-damaged tanks.
I was alone there. I was a project leader. I made my own pictures from every test.
Held detonated his shaped charges on the tank's turrets, fully expecting them to perforate the armor and destroy the tanks. But when he reviewed his footage, he noticed much bigger explosions than he had anticipated. Upon investigation, he discovered that the shaped charges had set off live ammunition still sitting in the turret. He realized that the secondary explosion had neutralized the effect of the shaped charges.
So the stronger reaction have reduced the penetration capability.
By accident, Held had discovered a new way to protect a tank: explosive reactive armor. Like many modern tanks, the Israeli Blazer features the new protection. Its most vulnerable points, the front arc and turret, are fitted with close to 40 reactive plates. If a plate is hit, it explodes, countering the shaped charge and leaving the tank unharmed. A demonstration reveals how it works. Two towers of steel stand in for the armor of a tank. Each will take the brunt of a shaped charge attack. A charge is placed on top of each tower. There will be two explosions, one with explosive reactive protection and one without. The one with gets a sheet of plastic explosive placed at an angle between the shaped charge and the top steel block. This simulates the position of the plate on a tank.
When the shaped charge is fired, it will detonate the sheet of plastic explosive and hopefully disrupt the blast. Then we can compare the number of steel plates penetrated with the protection of explosive reactive armor and without. Firing in 3, 2, One, firing! Firing! There was a huge release of energy in both those two explosions. This first stack, we didn't have anything between the shaped charge and the top plate.
The shaped charge left a neat entry hole, and the blast penetrated almost six plates. That's 6 inches of steel.
It's actually gone almost all the way through it. If we compare that to the stack that was protected by our simulated explosive reactive armor, the entry on the top plate is a lot messier. A lot of this seems to have been disrupted.
But the shaped charge has only gone through 3.5 plates. The explosive reactive armor has reduced the impact by almost half.
So had this been an attack on a tank, I think the protection offered by the explosive reactive armor could well have saved the crew's lives.
Once again, armor had caught up with the innovative weapons, intent on destroying it. Israel was the first to adopt the explosive reactive armor. It is just one of many safety features designed into Israel's main battle tank, the Merkava. After losing 2,500 men, most of them tank soldiers in the Yom Kippur War, the Israelis placed a high premium on tank crew protection. For such a small country with so few soldiers, the loss of highly skilled tank crews is a political, economic, and military tragedy. Soldiers are extremely precious, so their safety is the number one priority. Firepower and mobility come second and third. Unlike all other main battle tanks, the Merkava's engine is in front, which puts an extra barrier between the crew and incoming fire. The tank's shape, streamlined and flat, makes it difficult to hit. Even the turret is designed to present a low-profile target.
The turret is basically on the top. It's very narrow, so it will be very, very hard to hit. As you can see, it's shaped as an arrow to the front.
If the tank is hit, soldiers have an increased chance of survival because ammunition and flammable liquids are kept separate from the crew area. And the crew can make a rapid exit through a rear-facing escape hatch.
What happens, I give my crew just a command. They all get out of their cells and just come out of the tank from this rear hatch. We can open it from inside. It just opens on the top and on the bottom. The whole crew gets out and we go to a safer spot.
The Israeli Merkava represents the pinnacle of crew safety, a conscious decision by the Israeli Army to put protection first. Known as shaped charges, the warheads were designed to cut through even the thickest tank armor.
This is a shaped charge. The top part here is filled with explosive. This is designed so that when the explosion travels down here, this copper actually turns to liquid and is concentrated on a point down here. And that allows the liquid metal to actually puncture straight through the target.
It will completely carve up the crew, or it will set off ammunition fires, which in turn, of course, will produce internal explosions, which will completely finish them.
But of course, as soon as engineers realized what they were up against, they began searching for the next protective counterpunch to defend against it. In 1969, German armor scientist Manfred Held made a surprising discovery while conducting research in the Middle East. Held was testing shaped charge warheads on the wrecks of battle-damaged tanks.
I was alone there. I was a project leader. I made my own pictures from every test.
Held detonated his shaped charges on the tank's turrets, fully expecting them to perforate the armor and destroy the tanks. But when he reviewed his footage, he noticed much bigger explosions than he had anticipated. Upon investigation, he discovered that the shaped charges had set off live ammunition still sitting in the turret. He realized that the secondary explosion had neutralized the effect of the shaped charges.
So the stronger reaction have reduced the penetration capability.
By accident, Held had discovered a new way to protect a tank. Explosive reactive armor. Like many modern tanks, the Israeli Blazer features the new protection. Its most vulnerable points, the front arc and turret, are fitted with close to 40 reactive plates. If a plate is hit, it explodes, countering the shaped charge and leaving the tank unharmed. A demonstration reveals how it works. Two towers of steel stand in for the armor of a tank. Each will take the brunt of a shaped charge attack. A charge, a new way to protect a tank. Explosive reactive armor. Like many modern tanks, the Israeli Blazer features the new protection. Its most vulnerable points, the front arc and turret, are fitted with close to 40 reactive plates. If a plate is hit, it explodes, countering the shaped charge and leaving the tank unharmed. A demonstration reveals how it works. Two towers of steel stand in for the armor of a tank. Each will take the brunt of a shaped charge attack. A charge is placed on top of each tower. There will be two explosions, one with explosive reactive protection and one without. The one with gets a sheet of plastic explosive placed at an angle between the shaped charge and the top steel block. This simulates the position of the plate on a tank.
When the shaped charge is fired, it will detonate the sheet of plastic explosive and hopefully disrupt the blast. Then we can compare the number of steel plates penetrated with the protection of explosive reactive armor and without. Firing in 3, 2, 1, firing! Firing! There was a huge release of energy in both those two explosions. This first stack, we didn't have anything between the shaped charge and the top plate.
The shaped charge left a neat entry hole, and the blast penetrated almost 6 plates. That's 6 inches of steel.
It's actually gone almost all the way through it. If we compare that to the stack that was protected by our simulated explosive reactive armor, the entry on the top plate is a lot messier. A lot of this seems to have been disrupted.
But the shaped charge has only gone through 3.5 plates. The explosive reactive armor has reduced the impact by almost half.
So had this been an attack on a tank, I think the protection offered by the explosive reactive armor could well have saved the crew's lives.
Once again, armor had caught up with the innovative weapons intent on destroying it. Israel was the first to adopt the explosive reactive armor. It is just one of many safety features designed